因语而动，内容多元化，只要攞起手机就能够让祝福流动，将福音传送给家人和朋友。快啲嚟扫一扫呢个 QR code， 下载最新推出嘅因语移动 apps， 免费攞迎新礼品啦！
孤身一人从美国来到台湾，
那时候黑珍珠来到台湾哦，等于算是一个旋风，因为台湾那个时候没有黑人歌手，
他不认得一个人，他就敢提着行囊来到这样的地方。
语言不通，孤单无奈。
很多时候我觉得他是独处啊，因为语言的关系。
I cried every night。
他受到青少年的喜爱。
65,000 teenagers, and when I walked out, they all knew me. Sheila, Ama, they all knew me.
佢願意用更多時間為神歌唱。
I sing gospel in the nightclubs. No one else does that. 他要做商業的哦，他絕對做不完。
離開了固定的收入，所以他是憑信心過日子。For you sit in my heart, you are my rock.
在台湾北部淡水河的出海口，有一个蕴藏着丰厚历史的地区，热闹的老街，传统台湾小食，西洋建筑古迹，还有日据时代的房屋，这些都是淡水独有的特色。清朝时期，淡水是重要的港口，经常有外国船只在这里靠岸。河岸边的一个雕像就呈现了那时加拿大传教士马佳博士登陆的情形。带着一个药箱、一本圣经，马佳博士走遍大城小镇，透过帮助人掹牙、赠送药物、建立医馆、创建学堂，一点一滴将爱和基督信仰注入这一片土地。作为一个外国人，要克服语言的隔阂，融入台湾的文化和生活并不容易。最初马佳博士并没想过他的一生会留在台湾，同样没想过自己会来台湾的还有美国灵魂乐歌手 Serena London 黑珍珠。第一次来巡回表演之前，他对台湾一无所知。
Agent call, you want to go to Taipei? I'm like, where's Taipei?He said, Taiwan? I said, Thailand? He said, no, Taiwan. I was like, let me pray about it. I said, you know I don't travel by myself. I had a fear of going anywhere by myself. And it was during 911. So nobody was traveling. And God said, go. I cried. I was afraid to go by myself, terrified. But I'm more afraid to disobey God. And that's how I came. And I stayed 3 months here. And then I went and left and went to Singapore. Then I went back home. I did that two times.那时候黑珍珠来到台湾哦，等于算是一个旋风，因为台湾那个时候没有黑人歌手，所以他来台湾开始唱歌的时候，哇，每个人都疯了，怎么会有黑人唱歌唱成这样子？不止唱，还会跳舞。The third time I came back here, God said, "No, no warning, stay put." All I had was my clothes. I had no idea I was going to stay here. I didn't have.Friends, I didn't know the language because you know, you're in the nightclub, you're singing 3 months, everybody's there at night, but during the day, I knew you. I cried every night. I wanted to buy some cake, and I bought this cake, and I bent into it, and it was cold pork inside. I said, what's wrong with these people? Why is there pork in my cake? I wanted to buy some milk, I couldn't read it. And I bought it, and I want regular milk, it was strawberry milk. I just cried. I did. It was not easy, and the Lord wouldn't say,Stay here, I'm going to do this for you. He would just say, stay put. 不要动 stay put.
他不认得一个人，他就敢提着行囊来到这样的地方。我觉得他勇敢地回应神的呼召，这点我很佩服他。
Sometimes I didn't have food, but I wouldn't say anything. I just say, Lord, what am I going to eat now? I was paying my bills in America, my house, my car, my insurance, and the rent here, you know. God, I don't know how God did that. And then I would cry myself to sleep and he would, the phone ring, 5 jobs. He was my visa, he was my agent, he was my manager, he was, all I had was him. That's all I had. It was my hardest time, but my best time. I learned how to totally trust God.
在困境之中 ，Sorina 反而更加信靠神。其实她从小就跟妈妈翻教会，但是在成长的过程当中渐渐离开神。Sorina 一直梦想成为明星，高中毕业她就赢得选美比赛的冠军。进入表演行业之后，她做过模特儿、领舞，甚至兔女郎。
I was choreographer and lead dancer for a television show, and they interviewed a Playboy bunny.I didn't even know what a bunny was. Like, oh, I think I'll become a bunny. And somebody said, you can't be no bunny. Ugh, what did they say that for? You tell me something I can't do? Oh, I'm going to do it. I borrowed my friend's chinchilla mink and I put on diamonds and everything. And I went for the bunny interview. They said, oh no, you got too much going on. Keep doing what you're doing. You don't need to be a bunny. I'm thinking, what? So I waited a while.And I came back again. I just wore simple. Then we were in the mini dress, simple mini dress, boots. And then they interviewed me and I got the job. Still didn't know what a bunny was. You know, people just think you just put on a suit and you just go out there. No, no, no. And you had to call the drinks in order. The bartender had everything in order. If you didn't learn it in order, you were out. And you had to carry 10 to 12 drinks on a tray here.Plus a champagne bucket, and you'd have to go through the door, kick the door, coming through, kick it through, and to get through before the door crash over you, or hot plates. I carried 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hot plates. I mean, we worked. Everybody think it's just so glamorous. No, we worked, and at the end of the night, we were crying with those high heel pump shoes that I'm wearing now. They're back in style. And you know, I only wanted to do it to have it in my career because I was going to be a movie star.They asked me to pose for the Playboy magazine. Of course not. I said, I might be married to a pastor with 6 kids. There's no way. There's some things you just won't do. It's about sexy. Okay, I'll be sexy. But nude? Uh-uh. And all the other bunnies was like, you're kidding. You're not going to take because they, I mean, this was like, you get all this money and you get this car and then you get a definite movie career. It was like, nah, because it was important to me to work for it.I like to work for it. Like James Brown, I don't want nobody to give me nothing. Just open up the door, I get himself.
对于演艺事业 ，Sorina 一直都是积极进取，但是可惜几年之后，因为腿部关节炎，必须要做手术。这个手术改变了她的发展方向。
The doctors told me you'll never dance again and you'll never be able to wear high heels again and you'll never be able to run again. I was like, I can't go out like this. I'm supposed to be in entertainment. So in the meantime, I taught myself to sing. My mother used to tell me, would you shut up? My brother used to say, I sound like a wolf. Even in elementary school, when the kids go, Mary had a little lamb, my voice was like, Mary had a, I had this heavy voice, you know? So,I worked on that. I kept singing and practicing and practicing. So from then on, from the 70s on, singing, that was my job. And I did cabaret and I did jazz and I did soul. Then I changed costumes. I like showbiz, you know, theater. I was working 6, 7 days a week. I mean, I was turning down jobs. My fiance was a musician. You know, he was a singer, keyboard player. And then we got a band we called D&Z, D for Donald and Z for Zarina. And we were good. And we worked, we traveled, we went to Japan. We were in Singapore, lived in Singapore for a year with Malaysia. And I mean, we were really, really good. As a matter of fact, record companies wanted to sign me. They wanted me to be the new 1990s Tina Turner.
在表演上面 ,Sorina 越来越受欢迎。但是爱情却是慢慢变质。曾经被欣赏的优点成为了嫉妒的来源。
The very thing that attracted him to me, my free spirit, happy and how people, he used to say, I flirt with everybody, kids, men, women, I mean, I treat everybody the same. The very thing he liked and he became insecure about that, you know. He, very talented, very, very talented, but he was more like he wanted to be the back. I like the front line, you know, it's like, I can play, I'm a team player.But I like the front line. And they needed the front line. But people would come up and, you know, compliment me, and he would be jealous of that. But what really changed it was the manager introduced them to drugs. That really did it, the drugs. And it just really changed him and changed me. And yeah, he did become abusive. And he told me later, he thought that abusing me would make me stay. And he was afraid for me to be successful because he thought I'd leave him. But see, that no, he had it all wrong. I would have never left him down. I would have left him successful.
尽管受到家暴，但系 Sorina 冇离开。一方面佢唔想俾屋企人知道，另一方面佢自己亦都染上咗毒瘾。
And then I was telling him, "You're a drug addict." And he looked at me and said, "So are you?" I'm like, "No, I'm not." He said, "Try to stop." To my surprise, I don't think I can stop. But see, I was a functioning drug addict. Nobody knew I was using drugs. I worked. I sang. Not when I'm singing. Not when I'm performing. I had to be in control. That's one thing. I had to be in control. It was afterwards, and family didn't know.So nobody knows you, then they don't know you need help. 5 years I was addicted to it. And then one day I was in my room and he had in our room and he wanted me to get high. I got, well, I hated getting high, I hated it. And I remember praying inside, "Lord, this is not me. I don't like this. What's happened to me? Please help me and preserve me so that I can complete what it is I'm supposed to do."I didn't even know why I prayed that. And then I felt guilty, like, you're not supposed to talk to God when you're sinning? I mean, that's what Christians always said. And I got scared because I didn't even speak it. I just thought it. Waking up the next morning, I was sitting in the chair and this big warm breath came. And it was warm, nice. It was gentle but strong. And I opened my eyes and I heard the audible voice of God. This big round sound voice says,One day, you will speak on faith. And I went, no, 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 not me. You know, because I'm thinking, me? Do you realize I just got high last night? You know what I mean? And it scared me.
这个经历吓亲 Sorina， 但是更加令她惊讶的是，原来她是可以离开暴力和威胁，开始新生活的。
Our son, he was leaving us.So I left with my son. I had the courage to leave with my son. I left everything. Car, house, family pictures. I took some clothes of my son, my clothes. I left 2 weeks before our 18th anniversary. When I left him, my family had a liquor and grocery store. I became the manager of the store. I stopped singing. And I just was on fire for God. My brother-in-law told me I was bad for business because I was praying for people in the church and in the liquor store and they would stop drinking and stop smoking. He would say,I saw you praying on the camera in my, no praying in my store, no praying in my store. And you walk in, you hear, oh, save the Lord, oh. Then people are like, is this a liquor store or a church? You know, and that was, and while I was there, God sent a minister. His name was Minister Hudson. He became my spiritual father. And I kept asking him questions. I would keep him there for hours and hours. And he,was the one that led me back and I went to the church and he baptized me. I was doing my Bible study, smoking my cigarette, like drinking my coffee, smoking my cigarette, studying my Bible before I go. I didn't know. And then it got where I'm thinking, I don't want to smell like smoke. And I found out that my spiritual father said, no, smoking is not, it doesn't represent well. I'm like, okay, well, I need to quit. So, and I said, Lord, I've quit many times, but I always go back smoking.I say, so this time, I need you to help me keep my promise to you. Now, I'm working in the liquor and grocery store selling cigarettes all day. And people come in, oh, but you can take a few of mine. Take it. No. The Lord heard that prayer. If my cravings were here, he took it to here. I was able to sell cigarettes all day long, quit cold turkey. After the 2 weeks, he changed my life so much, I didn't know how much it changed. It just...things and things I used to like, I didn't like anymore. Even the way I dressed, I used to be dressed very sexy. You know, I was a Playboy bunny, I was very sexy. I wouldn't be new, but I'd be sexy. All of a sudden, then it's like, oh, I can't wear that. Nobody had to tell me. It's like, you know, I used to wear, you know, now I wear holy clothes. I used to have a, before it was a hole here, hole there, hole. Now I fill in the holes, you know, it's Holy Spirit. It's like, I'll wear the same thing, but it's filled in, you know?
I say again today, Father, I submit and commit the rest of my eternal life to you.
重新回到神的面前 ，Sorina 弃除陋习，连毒品都没办法再控制佢。
Sometimes my ex would call and say he was going to commit suicide, and then it was going to be my fault and it'd be on my head and feel guilty and stuff, and I would run over there. And But he would set me up. He would have drugs there. And a couple of times, I would fall into it, you know. And then I'd go back and I was like, oh no. And I'd call my spiritual father and say, I just went over there. I said, I used drugs again. He said, guess what? I forgive you. He said, did you repent? I said, yeah. He said, God's forgive you. God took it from me. He took the desire from me. I tell people, I didn't go to rehab. I went to Jesus. If you're serious about it and you want to be free, Jesus is real. He'll do it. But you gotta be serious. You know, he knows your heart.
Sorina 嘅生活完全被改变，热爱表演嘅佢重新翻舞台。嚟到台湾之后，佢喺餐厅演唱，喺婚礼或者大型活动里面嚟到表演。不过佢嘅内心一直向往为神歌唱。
I went to visit ORTV 空中英语 ，and I met Doris Brown. Wow, they sing gospel, so I'm like, I'd like to sing gospel sometime. I wanted to use my voice for God.And I was talking to Mama Doris. I called Mama Doris, and I say, I'd like to sing some gospel with Heavenly Melody sometime. She said, well, you need to give up what you're doing. I said, well, I don't think it's nothing wrong with me singing and making money and doing concerts and weddings, and I should be able to do that. She said, you know, you need to call me when you decide to, when you're ready to let everything go. I looked at the phone like, excuse you?I hung up the phone, you know, and then they had given me a CD. Somebody had given me a CD. I had the CD for a year, never opened it. And I opened it, put it in. It was I Surrender All. And I put that CD in there in my CD player. I surrender all. I surrender all. I turned that thing off. It come back on. I surrender all. The CD player stays stuck 2 days, 48 hours on. I surrender all. I said, okay, I get it.I surrender, you know, and what it was, because see, I had given my heart to God. I loved him. I only came to Taiwan because of God. But see, I hadn't given him my life. There is a difference. So then when I gave him my life, I'd already given my heart. I gave him my life and I gave him my career. I gave up all my contracts, everything. And she didn't know I was going to do that. I didn't know I was going to do that. After those 2 days, and I had to tell somebody, and I said, listen, I want everybody to know I have totally and completely surrendered my life to God. And they're like, whoa, she was so surprised. And then she said, why don't you be full time?I worked there 8 years. The Lord put me on doing rally tours. I would go around, see 50 to 80,000 kids every year in Taiwan. I would go to the schools and I would sing for them and I would dance for them. And then I would talk to them about suicide, drugs, not having sex. And I gave them concert. I used my expensive clothes. I treated them just like I would if I was at Carnegie Hall. You know, and the kids really appreciated that.We did a concert in Kaohsiung, 65,000 teenagers. And when I walked out, they all knew me. She, ha, ama, they all knew me. And they were saying, they would come to me, thank you that you care for us.
我非常开心今天我的好朋友，他是因为爵士乐带他来到台湾。他今天也是用爵士乐到处全世界在传神的福音。好不好，各位朋友们 ,Ladies and gentlemen, please use the most warmest applause to welcome黑珍珠。
平安，大家好，大家好。
Sorina 深受青少年嘅喜爱，但系佢冇就此满足，反而想花更多时间做更多传福音嘅工作。
其实黑珍珠他要做商业的哦，他绝对做不完。 任何的公司啊 event 一定都是指定他，只是他自己觉得说他要更花更多的时间在服事上面。但有时候做神的服事上真的是很辛苦哦，不管是在他的收入啊时间上面会很难很难去拿捏的。
Lord, you are my hope, my only hope, no one else can help me. Oh Lord, you are my hope.
I'm still a performer. They call me Evangelist Diva because, you know, but I sing gospel in the nightclubs. No one else does that. I keep leaving the nightclub, he keeps sending me back. I had a friend, great keyboard player. He committed suicide. When I found out, the Lord literally said to me, he said, you see? He said, I fixed you. I got you well, but you didn't go back and help. You know, because I saw him 2 weeks before, and he was saying, I'm really depressed. You know, my wife has left me. But we were in between shows. We couldn't talk. And 2 weeks later, he hung himself on a bridge here in Taiwan. I went over to the manager. I said, I want to do gospel here in your nightclub. And he said, okay, we do gospel for your God. We do gospel for your God. It was a miracle. When I keep leaving, he sent me back because he says, be in the world, but not of the world. In the world of entertainment. In the world of politics. In the world of education.
有时候我说，阿妈 ，What's up， 黑珍珠，我说我们有个表演，不是教会的，要不要做？I only do gospel， but 我们不是基督徒，他们不是基督徒，你怎么做 gospel？ 我跟他表演，他可以把每一首歌歌词现场全部改。
I changed the lyrics just like they had the song "Happy is happiness is the truth." I said, "Clap along if you feel that Jesus Christ is the truth." I changed that, you know, "Clap along if you know God's been good to you." And that other song, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus Christ. I love you, Jesus. For me, you gave your life.
我们在表演，哇，你即兴怎么嘛，全部都变成福音歌曲哦。所以我觉得他在他的职场上，他都想要传福音。就算他没有机会跟大家讲福音，他用唱的也在唱福音。
在职场上为主歌唱。在生活当中 ，Sorina 同样满怀热诚去关怀有需要的人。
他有一个热情，他很愿意为需要的弟兄姐妹来祷告。很多被他祷告过的弟兄姐妹会来告诉我，他们会有一种得释放啊，有的人病也得医治。
他很自然的会去爱每一个人，虽然语言不通。但是他很自然里面那个流露。我们最近去医院一直看一位老先生，他不但关心这位老先生，他还就关心同一个病房的其他人。我就会看到他非常用心的去鼓励每一位。
He kept me here in another country by myself, and he's just strengthening me. And how he took me.He heals through me. That blows me away. He's not looking for qualified people. He's looking for people to qualify. God explained to me, a pearl is made through injury. There's a grain of sand gets in that and irritates that. And then it comes out this beautiful pearl. So I've made a vow the rest of my life, every breath I have left, every heartbeat, for the rest of my eternal life, I will serve him.
就好似歌中所唱，主是我唯一盼望，我全心信靠。 Sorina 过去的伤痛被神的爱一层层覆盖，变成今日散发光彩的珍珠。
多谢大家收看恩语之声，如果想更多了解这个节目，欢迎打来我们的热线电话3106-4444，或者浏览我们的节目网页